Hi students, welcome back to video classes. So in the previous class, the exercise, we did the problems up to first Roman. Now we will continue the next problems. Second one is arrange the following in descending order. So first one is 2 by 9, 2 by 3, 8 by 21. Here, if you observe the fractions, the given fractions are unlike fractions. Why? Because the denominators are not same. 9, 3, 21, different denominators are there. Therefore, they are the unlike fraction. Now, you convert into the like fractions. So, what is the solution? Two by nine, two by three, 8 by 21 are unlike fractions. They are unlike fractions. Convert into like fractions. To convert into the like fractions, what we will do? We must find the LCM of the denominators. What are the denominators? We have 9, 3, 21. 9, 3, 21. So, you know how to find the LCM by using division method. It is very easy method. Now, so we can divide by 3. 3 threes are 9, 3 ones, 3 sevens. Now, and 3 and 7, nothing is going. These two are prime numbers. Therefore, LCM is equal to 3 into 1 into 7, which is equal to 63. 3, 3 is 9, 9, 1 is 9, 9, 7, 63. Now, LCM is 63. Now, you make the denominators of given fractions equal to 63. Therefore, write 1 by 1. Therefore, 2 by 9 is equal to 2 by 9 into which number is to be multiplied by this number 9 to get 63? Which number is to be multiplied? So, just receive the 9 table. 9 sevens are 63. 9 sevens are 63. Therefore, numerator also by 9. Why? Because to get the equivalent fraction, we have to multiply both numerator and denominator by same number. Here we are multiplying by 7. Now, 2 sevens are 14 by 9 sevens are 63. Now take the next fraction. 2 by 3, which is equal to 2 by 3 into, now here also same. So 3 should be multiplied by 21. 3 21s are 63. Numerator also by 21, which is equal to 2 21s are 42 by 63. Take the third fraction, 8 by 21, which is equal to 8 by 21 into, here if you observe this one, 3 21s are 21 threes, 63. So, if you multiply two numbers in any order, we get the same product, 2 into 23 are 21 into 3, both are same, that is equal to 3, 8 threes are 24 by 63. Now, these are all the like fractions. Why? Because these are all the like fractions. Why? Because the denominators are equal. Since, therefore, that means since now you compare the numerators. 14, 42, 24. 14, 42 and 24. Here, he asked to write into the descending order, big to small. Out of this, which is the biggest one? 42 is the biggest one. Therefore, 42 is greater than next 24 and then is greater than 14. Therefore, 42 by 63 is greater than 24 by 63 is greater than 14 by 63. This is the biggest one. This is the biggest one and this is the smallest one. Therefore, finally, we can write thus 42 by 63 means 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is greater than 24 by 63 means 8 by 21. 8 by 21 is greater than 14 by 63 means 2 by 9. 2 by 9. Therefore, we can write the same thing as 2 by 3, 8 by 21, 2 by 9. Like that, we can write the given numbers in descending order. Now, come to the second one. 1 by 5, 3 by 7, 7 by 10. So, this is same as the first one. Why? Because different denominators are there. Make the denominators equal to LCM. That means first you find the LCM of 5, 7 and 10. So, you will get some LCM. Now, you make all the denominators equal to LCM. That means you convert into the like fraction as usual, just like this. So, this is HW. Now, come to the third one. In a magic square, the sum of the numbers in each row, in each column and along the diagonals is the same. Is this a magic square? Is this a magic square means if you get the sum of the numbers in each row, each column and each diagonal is same, then it is called a magic square. Let us find the sum of the fractions in what we call first row. So, according to the problem, solution is first we'll add the fractions in row wise. Sum of the fractions in first row means what are the fractions we have? 4 by 11, 9 by 11, 2 by 11. You add these. 4 by 11 plus 9 by 11 plus 2 by 11. Here, these fractions are like fractions. Like fractions means, what is the rule we have? Sum of the like fractions is equal to sum of the numerators by common denominator. Here, what are the numerators we have? 4, 9, 2. If you add all these numbers, 4 plus 9, 13, 13 plus 2, 15. Sum of the numerators is 15 by common denominator is 11. So, 15 by 11 is the sum of the fractions in first row. So, like that, you find the sum of the fractions in second row. Second row is 3 by 11, 5 by 11 and 7 by 11. Same. 3 by 11, 5 by 11 and 7 by 11. Here also sum of the fractions 3 plus 5, 8, 8 plus 7. Here also we got same 15 by 11. So like that you find the third row. Sum of the fractions in third row. 8 by 11 plus 1 by 11 plus 6 by 11. So, 8 by 11 plus 1 by 11 plus 6 by 11, which is equal to sum of the fractions 8 plus 1, 9 plus 6, 15 by 11. Here also we get the same. So, in these three cases, we will get the same sum 15 by 11. Now, we will see the sum of the fractions in what we call row and in each column. So, first column. So, what are the fractions we have? vertically, column means vertically, 4 by 11 plus 3 by 11 plus 8 by 11. Now write down 4 by 11 plus next 3 by 11 plus 8 by 11. 3 by 11 plus 8 by 11. So same, these are the like fractions. Add the numerators, 3 plus 4, 7 plus 8, 15. 15 by 11. So just like a second column. What are the fractions we have? 9 by 11, 5 by 11, 1 by 11. Add it. 9 by 11 plus 5 by 11 plus 1 by 11, which is equal to same as 9 plus 5, 14 plus 1, 15 by 11. So like that you add the third column. What are the fractions? 2 by 11, 7 by 11, 6 by 11. 2 by 11 plus 7 by 11 plus 6 by 11, which is equal to here also we'll get 15 by 11. Now some of the fractions in first diagonal, what is the diagonal we have? So corner to corner, so 8 by 11, 5 by 11, 2 by 11. Second diagonal, 4 by 11, 5 by 11 and 6 by 11. Therefore first diagonal, some of the fractions in first diagonal, take this one, 4 by 11 plus 5 by 11 plus 6 by 11, corner to corner, 4 by 11 plus, this is 4 by 11 plus 5 by 11 plus 6 by 11 plus 6 by 11, which is equal to 4 plus 5, 9, plus 6, 15. Here also we got 15 by 11. Like that, second diagonal. Second diagonal. What are the fractions we have? 2 by 11 plus 5 by 11 plus 8 by 11. 2 by 11 plus 5 by 11 plus 8 by 11. Here also some other fractions, 2 plus 5, 7 plus 8, 15 by 11. Here all the sums are same, 15 by 11, 5 by 11, same 15 by 11, 15 by 11, 15 by 11. We will get the same sums here. Therefore here all the, what we call, sums are same. Therefore yes, the question is, is this a magic square? Is this a magic square? Therefore yes, it is a magic square. Yes, it is a magic square. Why? Because we got the answers are same. So next, come to the next problem. A rectangular sheet of paper is 12 1 by 2 centimeters long and 10 2 by 3 centimeters wide. Find its perimeter. Whenever such type of problems are there, means you just draw a figure. So better to draw a figure. Solution. So you know the shape of the rectangle, means opposite sides are equal. In a rectangle, opposite sides are equal. So here this is the sheet of paper, and what is its length? 12 1 by 2 centimeters. This is 12 1 by 2 centimeters long, and 10 2 by 3 centimeters is wide. Wide means its breadth is 10 2 by 3 centimeters wide. Find its perimeter. As we know that, just write down length. what is the length given? Length is denoted by L equal to 12 1/2 centimeters. You better to convert into the improper fraction. Whenever, if there is a mixed fraction, convert into the improper fraction. Whatever the operation is, whether it is addition, subtraction, multiplication, whatever it may be, first you convert into the improper. 2 12s 24 plus 1 25 by 2 centimeters. And breadth means width. Breadth B is equal to 10 2 by 3 centimeters. This is also converted to the improper. 10 3 is 30 plus 2. 32 by 3 centimeters. Now, according to the definition, some of the lengths of the sides of the figure, we can find the perimeter. Therefore, what is the perimeter means? Perimeter. P is equal to how much, he asked. According to the definition, we can find the perimeter. So, what is that? Sum of the lengths of the sides of a figure. Here, 12 1/2 centimeter. If it is 12 1/2 centimeters, what about this one? This is also equal to 12 1/2 centimeters. Breadth is 10 2/3. This is also equal to 10 2/3. Therefore, according to the definition, we can find the perimeter as 12 1/2 centimeters plus 10 2/3 centimeters plus 12 1/2 centimeters plus 10 2/3 centimeters. So, like that, we can find the perimeter. So, it takes more time. By using formula, we can find the perimeter. What is the formula used to find the perimeter? P is equal to 2 into L plus B. Why? Because in perimeter, two lengths and two breadths are there. So, here, suppose if you open it, 2 into L, 2L plus 2B, two lengths plus two breadths. So, 2 into L, 2 into L means substitute the value of L and B in this one. What is the value of L? 25 by 2. 25 by 2 plus breadth means 32 by 3. 32 by 3 right centimeters. Now, which is equal to, so as we know that the addition of two fractions means the fraction should be like, but here unlike fractions are there. So, convert into the like means we have to find the LCM, but here two fractions are there. So, you need not find the LCM. We can convert into the like fractions by cross multiplication. That means here first fraction, numerator and denominator, you should multiply numerator and denominator by the denominator of the second fraction, and second fraction, numerator and denominator by the denominator of the first fraction. Like that, we convert into the like fraction. Now, you see. 2 into 25 by 3 means 25 into 3. How much 25 threes are? 75. Just observe it carefully. 25 into 3. Here we are multiplying these two numbers by 3. 25 3 is 75 by 2 threes. 25 3 is 75. 2 3 is 6. Plus, come to the second fraction. Same, apply the same rule. 32 and 3 should multiply by 2, 32 into 2, which is equal to 64 by 3 into 2, 6. Now, you see, these two are like fractions. These two are like fractions. As we know that sum of the like fractions is equal to sum of the numerators by common denominator. What are the numerators we have? 75 plus 64, add it, by common denominator is 6. So, which is equal to 75 plus 64, how much? 4 plus 5, 9, 6 plus 7, 13. This is equal to 139 by 6 centimeters. Now, multiply these two. We can cancel here. 2 ones, 2 threes. So, 139 by, so what we call? 3. If you divide this number, we will get some mixed fraction. Or otherwise, you can multiply these two. 2 139s are 239 sir, 278 by 6 centimeters. This is improper fraction. Convert into the mixed fraction. You convert here. Divide this 278 by 6. 6 fours are 24, 6 5 30. Big number. So 6 is 4 times only. 6 fours 24. Minus it. 7 minus 4, 3. Down 8. So 6 6 are 36. Minus it 2. Remainder is 2. That is equal to 46. 2 by 6 centimeters. So this is the mixed fraction. Here also we can simplify it. Why? Because 2 and 6. In 2 and 6 we can cancel by 2. 2 ones here. 2 ones 2, 2 threes 6, which is equal to, we can write the same thing as 46. 1 by 3 centimeter is the, therefore, perimeter of a paper is equal to this much. Okay, students, let us stop here. We will continue in the next video.